Here's the caliper enclosure, or whatever is the name of this. You can see the state it was before. So it's pretty rusty, you know, all black from the rust. And I'm using the wire wheel on a drill, and you can see some of the difference, right? So that's going through the wire wheel. I'm not really started yet. That was just a quick run through, and you can see what it looks like on the other side that has not gone through with our wire wheel. So I'm gonna go through this with a wire wheel, and then I'll just review it after I finish with a wire wheel. And in the end, I'm gonna sand it, probably with some of these also attached to the drill. Right, so here's the bracket. It's been sanded with, well, I took the wire wheel at it to it, and then I took the sandpaper to it, and Dremel, and this. So this is pretty much as good as I can get it without using the sandblaster, which I don't intend to use this time because it just leaves a mess all over the workshop. But yeah, it's not ideal, but it will do for my purposes of just trying and seeing what happens. So I'm going to prime it and take another picture afterwards. So it's been about 5 minutes, and I've put the bracket in my vise, or whatever is the name of this, and I just put a coat of primer on it, so you can still the shine, which means it's still wet. I've literally just finished spraying, but yeah, that's what it looks like. We'll find out what it looks like in the end when the job is done. I hope that this is actually showing the state of the caliper. From the inside it looks pretty good, but there is some rust inside. Not much I can do because I can't really reach it. Now Eric the car guy said just scrape it with a whatever this is. So this would be a flathead screwdriver actually, if my brain wants to work today. And yeah, stuff does come out. Can't see anything, but there is rust coming out of there, so it does feel like I'm doing something productive for a change. It's not like one of those works that you do something and you just believe that you've done it. Here I can actually see rust coming out, or dirt, because this may be left over from the paint, that just lets skin through. If I had a good place to do it, I would just use my sandblaster. Just aim there and clean everything and then go through it again with air, but I'm fairly happy with what it looks like right now. Difficult to show, obviously. Where is that camera? Yeah, impossible to show. But yeah, it's. I believe it will do its job. It's not perfect, it's not gonna last a lifetime, but since I can do it again in 2 years if I need to, if I still have this car. So yeah, starting by cleaning up again. Brake fluid to use. Now, let's see if I can remember how to do this. I need to put the square cut seal first, and then I'll have to figure a way to put the dust boot. That's going to be the difficult bit, because I already tried to reassemble this with the old parts while I was waiting for the refactoring, the rebuild pack to come. So putting a piston in is easy. Putting a square cut seal is supposed to be easy, or at least to put an old one is. The rubber boot seal, my old one, which is somewhere around here. This one. My old rubber butt seal is just too loose. Somehow it dilated to an area which is much, much bigger than where it fits. So when I tried to fit it back in, it would just have loose ends where the dust would get back in. I suspect that's what happened that made it fail in the first place. So I'm just hoping that this one is smaller, and it does look a lot smaller actually, which is good. So it may not be such a big problem to put it. When the rubber dust seal is there, the next bit to put is the metal clip, which is here, or my old one. So basically for this car, for the Toyota Celica from 1998, and I'm assuming it will be for all of them since 94 till 99. There are some models that was sold in 2000 in the UK, but they're very rare. Anyway, for this brake caliper, which sits on that car, you'll find this retaining ring, which just pushes outwards when you clip the boot inside. So, yeah, all of this came in a pack. The pack also came with a little valve or cover for the bleeding point, which is here. So that was nice of them. The bleed valve I do have now, just a little cap to put on it. Don't ignore those caps. Those caps are actually important. Because if you don't have the cap, you can have some dust coming into the bleed valve and clog it, and then you can't bleed your brakes, or you can't bleed them easily. Eric the car guy got a tip on that, so I'll just post it in a link. And it's enough talking, I just actually want to get this thing done. Thank you. this is just some brake fluid from previous jobs I've done.
I still have plenty of brake fluid left over. If you buy a Lotus Elan from the early 90s, you will probably spend a lot of time bleeding it. Because you gotta trust those brakes. They just don't feel like normal Toyota brakes, and I've only driven Toyotas all my life. So that car made me spend a lot of brake fluid until I realized that I had it bled, it's just that the brakes work like that.
So I'm putting the square cut seal in place. This should be a fairly easy job. It's just a matter of pushing it in until it's fully there. And it's incredibly difficult to do it with a single hand. But there you go. One thing, don't use anything to lubricate this except brake fluid. And I'm just lubing it as well as I can. So yeah, that was the easy bit. Now I've got my caliper, which it's already lubed. Or I believe it is, because it does feel a bit greasy. But there's no harm in putting a bit extra. Now, I've seen multiple attempts to do this, and one of them, which I think it's going to be the easiest way to do it, is to sit the dust boot in place and then push it through in over the piston. Use air compressed there to just make it expand. This is gonna just give it, I'm gonna give it a try, see what comes out. This boot just slotted in. That just proves that it's the right size, it's not too big like my old one that expanded. that made my life a lot easier. Now I just need to put the retaining ring, which may be a bit extra work. So we'll see how difficult that is, but it doesn't look difficult at the moment. But this retaining ring is not as easy as it looked. And yeah, this position for the camera is crap, so I do apologize for that. I do believe that is now in place. So it's just a matter of lubing up everything again. And, well, see what happens now. Well, although I had no problem with my old seal to fit in the inner part because it was rather loose, now I just can't expand it over the piston, so I'm going to have to find a different way to do it, which will probably end up being like Eric the car guy has done in his video. So I need to take this retaining ring again and everything out. Thank you. Now, what I've seen being done is something on these lines. Whoop. Right, so I'm just expanding the inner bit around the piston without it, hopefully, and hoping that it just won't slide off like it's been doing for every single attempt so far. And it's gone in, and I just pushed it out again. Right, so this may take a few tries. Maybe if I put too much oil on it, or brake fluid in this case. Right, so it's in place now. So now I just need to find a way, the right place to slot in this. Well, this is not going to work for me. Ah, crap. I really don't want to make this dirty. Top tip, use a clean workbench. Right, I'm just going to sit the piston in. Fully compress it. This is just another attempt. No need to say it may not work. Don't worry, this is a leather head armor and copper on the other side, so I'm not going to damage the piston. Do not hammer with a normal hammer like this. No, don't do that. That just damages your piston. This should not damage the piston because it's a softer surface. All I'm trying to do is just align the piston so it will go in. There you go, it's gone in. It's been aligned. Oh, look at that beauty. I have the piston fully compressed. I am not particularly worried if I need to push it out because I can use compressor for that. And now I'm going to try to put the seal again, which looks like it's going to be a much easier job. Oh yes. Now I'm putting the retaining ring, which is going in surprisingly easy. So I just ensure that the... So now I have the retaining ring inside, the piston inside. All I have to do is put this slip on the outside of the piston. Now, my first attempt is to simply expand the piston up till halfway or so. So I just have room to do the job, but without actually taking the piston out. Now obviously this may go wrong, but if you don't try, you will never find out. And I'm using my old brake caliper, the one that is already very worn, to just stop it with a piece of wood, just in case you can't see it. Now I need to put the bleed valve back in, otherwise the air will escape from the bleed valve, and I might as well lube the bleed valve. If you have one of those nozzles with the rubber, that just isolates, you know, you just flip it in and the air won't really escape, so you're fine. If you have a metal one, it's a bit trickier. Now, what I've done is simply put some tape around it. I just put tape around it, it makes that little, you know, fluffy feel that you can just push in and it will stop the air from coming out. So that's what I'm trying to do, well, that's what I'm going to do now. As soon as I can find some tape. Might as well do that in front of the camera, just because it looks good. You don't need to make a perfect fit, you just need something that will keep the air from coming out. Now, never put your hand in the middle, and I need to center this. Might as well also aim this a little bit lower. So never put your hand in the middle, just lift something else there. You may be safe to put your hand behind. Now I feel pretty safe because I've got the caliper. Caliper, it's pretty much really tough metal, and then just hold it there and there you go, popped out straight away, mostly because it's well lubed. Take out the studs and now just put the lip back in, and the piston is going back in, which is funny to see.
I need to find a different version of this, some way to stop it from going backwards. Let's try this again.
I just put the lip around, but I didn't really slot it in the small indentation in the piston. So second attempt will probably get me there. That is not expanded enough. so I need a smaller. Now the retaining ring came out. That was not the intention. Right, so the phone is now charging. I did run out of memory, so I had to just dump everything in the computer and start recording again. So in the meanwhile, what you've missed was basically the finish up of the job. Now I reckon this took about 20 minutes to fit this, probably the whole job, half an hour, but I think I was lucky. I'm not 100% sure the job is a good job. But the caliper does come out and back in without the seal coming out. I have no clue if it retracts with a square cut seal, but that's when we are, the only way for me to test it is to actually fit it in. So what I have here basically, it's a rebuilt caliper for 15 quid and a couple hours work and a lot of hours painting. You know, you only take this job as far as you want it, but I just thought painting was worth it. And it looks pretty good, it slides very easily. I've never had a caliper sliding this easily, which was funny to see. So yeah, there's just an overview of what it looks like in the end, so it's... And I really need some better light as well, but I'm happy with the result. I'm going to fit it in the car and test drive, see what happens. Right, so I'm outside now. The car is currently on a stand, on a, whatever is the name of that thing. I believe it's called an axle stand. I am going to put the jack also there, because I don't want to go underneath without a safety feature. As you can see, I have the brake line blocked with my DIY method, which probably didn't work, but we'll find out later. And basically the job now, it's to grab this caliper, which has these two bolts that need to be fitted in, and they will go in here, and hopefully I'm filming this correctly, here and here. Straightforward job, just a little bit of grease, bolt everything together, put the wheel back in, put the hose, clamp the hose, you know, and unclamp this, and then just bleed the brakes.